President, please be seated.
The court is now back in session, and again the floor is given to the deputy co-prosecutor to continue putting questions to the witness.
You may proceed.
Thank you. Good afternoon again, witness.
Le co-procureur, merci.
Is it fair to say that when you came back from your training in Phnom Penh and went to the airfield for the second time, your conditions improved?
Vos conditions se sont améliorées.
When I returned to work at the Kampong Chenang, I worked for the terrain surveying section, and the work was lighter in nature than the previous work that I did.
And were others in your unit doing the same work that you did when you first went to the airfield?
Continuait-il à faire ce que vous, vous aviez fait à votre arrivée sur le chantier?
Workers in that unit continued to work under the same conditions like the one I did previously.
I'd just like to talk about hygiene. When you were there for the first 2 months before the training,
did
workers from your unit, did they get to wash and shower? Did they have bath facilities,
toilets,
all those facilities to keep clean and healthy?
Before I went to attend the training,
avant la formation,
while I was working there, there was no hygiene whatsoever. There were so many flies, and the flies would come to the food that you ate.
Et les mouches se posaient sur la nourriture que l'on mangeait.
You mentioned earlier that you saw people die from starvation and overwork. What happened to their bodies? Were they given a funeral ceremony? Were they buried? Were they cremated? Do you know what happened to them?
Une cérémonie? Ont-ils été incinérés? Savez-vous ce qu'il est advenu de ces personnes?
At that time, if a worker died, there would be no ritual ceremony for the dead, but the dead body would simply be buried away.
Il était tout simplement enterré.
Did workers from your unit have the opportunity to leave the work site and visit families and friends?
Avaient-ils la possibilité de quitter le chantier pour aller voir leurs amis, leur famille?
We could not even go crossing through another unit working nearby.
That was even prohibited.
Does that mean that when people were working, they were guarded
by guards? Cela veut-il dire qu'il y avait des gardes qui surveillaient ceux qui étaient en train de travailler.
Yes, there were guards watching over us.
Oui,
and
il y avait des gardes qui nous
walked away from the unit, then that
si
worker would be accused of being enemy.
L'on était accusé d'être un ennemi.
Did the guards
Question.
Carry weapons or not?
Ces gardes étaient-ils armés ou pas?
The guards for the unit did not carry any weapon.
De l'unité ne portaient pas d'armes.
Did the guards wear different clothes to the people that were working?
D'autres vêtements, des vêtements différents de ceux des travailleurs.
Yes,
Réponse.
The guards
oui.
wore different uniforms, and it was in a form of a military uniform.
Cet uniforme ressemblait à un uniforme militaire.
Can you explain
Question.
About how many guards there were?
Pourriez-vous nous dire combien
For example,
de gardes il y avait?
If there was
Par exemple,
30 or 40
s'il y avait
workers working in an area, would there be one guard or two guards or more guards? Can you give us an idea of the proportion of people doing the work, the labor, compared to those guarding?
Two guards would be assigned to watch over a group of 30 or 40 workers. However, the guards were always on patrol. They did not remain stationed in one place.
Au même endroit, en permanence.
And did any of those guards come from your unit,
Question. K4? Certains de ces gardes venaient-ils de votre unité, unité K4?
None of the workers from my unit was assigned as a guard.
De mon unité n'a dû être garde.
You mentioned that there were members from Division 450 at the airfield in your statement. Were any of those members of that division, were any of them guards?
Parmi les membres de cette division, certains étaient-ils gardes?
I did not know about that, and they probably belonged to another division, and I was prohibited from walking around. I only knew about the situation in my unit.
Mais pour ce qui me concerne, je ne connaissais que la situation.
And did you know which military division or military unit that was running the airfield, operating it, managing it?
Du terrain d'aviation qui était responsable.
No, I
Réponse.
Did not really know
non,
about the leadership group in charge of the airfield work site.
Du chantier de construction.
And
question.
One last question on this.
Une dernière question
Do you know
sujet.
Which military group the guards may have belonged to?
Ces gardes appartenaient éventuellement.
I did not know about that.
Réponse, je n'étais pas au courant.
And I saw guards on patrol at night time in the area where I were sleeping.
À l'endroit où je dormais.
And
question.
Talking about when you were with your unit before you went for training.
Et pour
did the guards get the same work conditions as your unit?
Est-ce que les gardes
did they have to work as long?
Que les membres de votre unité? Est-ce que leurs heures de travail étaient les mêmes?
I did not see those guards during the daytime, and
réponse,
I did not know where they were during the time.
Je ne sais pas où ils étaient.
And I did not know any of them.
Et je n'en connaissais aucun.
You've talked about
question.
Having insufficient food
vous avez dit
when you
que
were
vous manquiez de nourriture
there for the first time.
Lorsque vous travailliez là-bas pour la première
you've talked
fois.
About people dying of
vous avez
overwork
dit que des gens avaient été
and of starvation.
De surmenage et de faim.
Did you see any of the guards dying of starvation
des gardes
or
mourir
overwork?
De faim ou de surmenage?
No. Those who did the guard duty
réponse.
At night did not see any worker who died during
nuit,
the working hours.
N'ont pas vu les ouvriers qui mouraient pendant les heures de travail.
I'm just asking what you saw.
Question,
did
je
you
vous demande
see
ce que vous
any
avez
guard
vu, vous,
die of starvation
des gardes
or overwork?
Mourir de faim ou de surmenage?
Or was it just the workers that you saw
ou bien était-ce seulement les
die
ouvriers
of that?
Que vous avez vu mourir ainsi?
Allow me to
réponse.
Say again that I did not see any guards
died
from overwork or starvation.
And de faim
the only
surmenage.
People who died
les
from overwork or starvation were those workers.
Les
and if the worker
question.
Was feeling ill,
et si
well,
un ouvrier se sentait mal.
Did you ever see any of the workers?
Tombé malade.
Ill or unwell, and would they get medical treatment? Did they get medical treatment?
Pouvait-il être
from
soigné?
What you saw?
Lui donnait-on des médicaments? Et avez-vous vu si c'était le cas ou pas?
For workers who were ill,
réponse.
Only when their condition was serious, that is, they could not get up anymore, then
malade,
the person would be sent to the medical unit.
Était envoyé à l'unité médicale, mais seuls ces malades-là étaient envoyés à cette unité.
When you were at the airfield.
Question. Lorsque vous étiez
could you
sur le
complain
site de l'aéroport,
about not having enough food?
Pouviez-vous vous plaindre
could you
de
complain
ne pas
about
à votre faim?
Having to work too hard?
Pouviez-vous vous plaindre du fait que vous deviez travailler trop
could
dur?
You complain about
pouviez-vous vous plaindre
not having enough hygiene facilities to wash?
les conditions d'hygiène n'étaient pas suffisantes.
Did you feel comfortable complaining about that?
Étiez-vous suffisamment à l'aise pour vous plaindre de la sorte lorsque vous étiez là-bas?
In terms of having food with no sanitation whatsoever, we didn't dare to complain.
Even
if
the
shower soup, the Khmer shower soup that we had with water lily, with morning glory,
even if it's
hard, we could not complain. We had to eat the morning glory.
De liseron d'eau n'était pas suffisant. Can you remind us
why you couldn't complain?
Et pourriez-vous nous dire
what was the atmosphere like at the airfield?
Pourriez-vous nous parler
why
de
did you not feel comfortable
sur le chantier?
To complain?
Pourriez-vous nous dire pourquoi vous n'étiez pas suffisamment à l'aise pour vous plaindre?
In such a
situation, if we were to complain, we would be accused of being a spoiled person
and
of being an enemy against Anka. So we had to keep our mouth shut, meet our lips, and just focus on working.
And just briefly, on the all the different work activities that were going on at the airfield, from what you can remember, both before your training and after your training, can you tell us the types of work that was being done to build the airfield and the buildings around? What types of things were people doing?
Sur le site, pourriez-vous nous dire quelles étaient les activités menées à bien?
During the work at the
airfield work site,
pour ceux
there were
various
groups that people were assigned to, for instance,
il y avait différents groupes
to pull grass at the airfield.
Certains devaient désherber,
while others would engage in the compacting the soil from the earth carrying trap. So there were all kinds of activities going on at the time.
And the activities that you did before you went to Phnom Penh, I think you said you were pulling grass. What other activities were you doing before you learned how to be a land surveyor?
Avant d'apprendre à devenir un arpenteur.
Before I was sent for training in Phnom Penh,
avant d'être envoyé
I was assigned to pull grass, to dig out the roots of grass and trees.
Je devais débarrasser la route de toutes les mauvaises herbes.
And were others in your unit assigned to do that as well?
Question, les autres membres de votre unité devaient-ils faire la même chose?
We all did the same work.
Réponse, nous faisions tous la même chose.
And Was your leg still a problem? You said you had a broken leg.
Vous dites que vous étiez cassé la jambe.
Was there any lasting pain or injury coming from that leg whilst you were working?
Cette jambe alors que vous travailliez?
While I was working there,
lorsque j'étais au travail,
I simply forced myself to do it.
Je me forçais
it was
à faire ce travail.
The mentality that forced me to do it. Physically, I was not capable
force,
of doing it
même si je n'étais
because
pas
of my leg injury,
physique,
but I had to do it, to force myself to do
je
it.
Devais le faire, je devais me forcer à le faire.
And can you tell us
question.
How it felt?
Et
how
me
it
dire
felt
ce que vous avez
to be pulling the grass
vous deviez désherber,
with the injured leg,
vous étiez
with
blessé
insufficient
la jambe,
food,
vous ne mangiez pas votre faim,
with lack of sleep,
vous ne dormiez pas suffisamment,
with no hygiene facilities.
Il n'y avait pas d'infrastructure
how did it
pour
feel?
L'hygiène.
Can you describe that to the court?
Pourriez-vous nous dire ce que tout cela vous
please.
A fait ressentir? Pourriez-vous décrire vos sentiments?
Allow me to inform the chamber about this.
Réponse.
At that time,
voilà ma réponse
I felt that
de la chambre.
I was like a dead person.
À l'époque, j'avais l'impression d'être déjà
that
mort.
I already died and I never
j'avais
thought
l'impression
that
d'être mort.
I would survive.
Je ne pensais absolument pas que j'allais survivre.
I thought that I would die from overwork.
Je pensais que j'allais mourir à force de trop travailler.
Exhaustion and that I would go and meet my parents.
Que j'allais retrouver mes parents.
I lost contact with my parents for several years at that stage.
Avec mes parents
and I was thinking of them and sometimes I vaped while I was about to sleep. And I was hopeless
avant de dormir,
because of the condition of the working condition on site.
De travail sur le chantier.
Did the guards?
Question.
Were the guards treated differently?
Les gardes étaient-ils traités
différemment? To you and your unit.
Différemment de vous et des membres
did the guards
de votre unité?
Have the same conditions?
Bien, les gardes
you've just talked
dans
about.
Les mêmes conditions que celles que vous avez décrites.
Allow me to inform the chamber that I
réponse.
Did not see
dire à
any
de la
guard
chambre,
engaging in any work that the workers were doing,
le
and I only saw them on patrol at night time while we
je
were resting, and we were not allowed to speak to any of them.
Et nous n'avions pas le droit de leur parler.
Thank you.
Question. Merci.
Mr. Witness, I'd like to move to another topic,
Monsieur le témoin,
if we can.
Passer à un autre sujet, si possible.
Moving away from the conditions
je m'éloigne de la
that people endured
des conditions
at the airfield
endurées par les ouvriers
and
sur le
discussing
chantier.
A little more
j'aimerais
about
à présent
arrests,
discuter
arrests
plus
that occurred.
Des arrestations.
You said to us that
vous nous avez dit
before you came to the airfield,
qu'avant d'arriver
there were
sur
arrests
le terrain d'aviation,
in your division.
Il y avait eu des arrestations
but now, I would like you
unité.
To think about when you were at the airfield,
mais j'aimerais maintenant que vous réfléchissiez
were
au moment
there arrests
où vous étiez
occurring?
Sur le terrain d'aviation.
And I want,
dire, si
before you answer,
il y a eu des
I want to
avant
refresh
vous
your memory with the statement that you gave
la
to
en un
the investigator
de votre
as to what you said.
Des
and then we can ask have a discussion about that.
Je vais relire ce passage, ensuite nous pourrons en discuter.
I'm referring back to the original statement that was quoted, Mr. President.
Je parle in your statement, you said
trucks came to arrest people
vous avez dit que
every
des
night,
arrêter les gens toutes
arresting
les nuits,
about 20 each time.
Qu'ils arrêtaient environ 20 personnes à chaque
at
fois.
Meetings, they called out names for people
quand
to leave the meeting
les noms de personnes étaient
and
cités,
to be arrested
ces personnes
at once.
Devaient sortir et qu'elles étaient arrêtées immédiatement.
Of my unit, only 14 remain alive.
Seules 14 personnes ont survécu.
Is that correct? When you were at the airfield,
tout cela est-il
these
exact.
Frequent
lorsque
arrests
sur le chantier,
were continuing
y a-t-il eu fréquemment des
every
arrestations
night.
De ce genre? Ces arrestations ont-elles eu lieu toutes les nuits?
Allow me to inform the chamber in this regard.
À ce sujet, j'aimerais dire à la chambre.
More arrests were being conducted while I was working at
je travaillais
unit 317
au sein de
l'unité 317 and that's when the arrests were intensified and in my unit only 14 remained.
Et au sein de mon unité, seuls 14 membres ont survécu.
Are you saying then from the 400 people that were in your unit
and
before you went to the airfield
avant votre arrivée sur le chantier,
only 14
seuls 14
have
de ces personnes,
you've only seen 14 again since 1979. Is that correct?
Dites-vous que vous avez vu revu seulement 14 de ces personnes après 1979.
After 1979,
réponse.
That is after the
après
liberation,
1979, après la libération,
only 14 of us met and we spoke about what happened, and that's how I knew that only 14 of us
seuls
survived.
Seuls 14 d'entre nous se sont revus, et c'est ainsi que nous
of
avons appris que
the
seules
men
14 personnes avaient
that
survécu.
You remember in your unit,
question.
K4,
au sein de votre unité
other than
K4,
those 14, have you ever seen those men
outre ces 14
again?
Personnes, avez-vous revu d'autres personnes?
Besides the 14,
réponse. Outre ces 14
I
personnes,
else from my unit returned.
Je n'ai vu personne de mon unité.
We'll talk about the intense period where there were arrests from your unit.
Nous parlons de la période pendant laquelle il y a eu beaucoup d'arrestations.
Before you
de
went
votre
to the
unité,
airfield, but
avant
for
que
now,
vous arriviez sur le terrain d'aviation.
Is it the case that there were arrests at the airfield that you saw
des arrestations sur le terrain d'aviation
and trucks
également
came with people to arrest
des
them?
Camions sont-ils venus arrêter des gens sur le chantier? Ai-je bien compris?
In
K4 unit regiment 317, more arrests were made in these two respective units. However, while I worked at Kampong Chnang, I did not see many arrests.
Did you see any arrests at Camp Anchenang? And if you saw any arrests, can you explain what happened?
While I worked in Kampong Chenang, I saw the arrests as well, but the frequency of the arrests were less than that at Khmuin Kopsreu. I think the arrests in Kampong Chenang were for the remaining alleged enemies that they did not arrest at Khmuin
Kopsreu.
Are you saying that there were arrests at Camp Anchenang of people from your unit, even if they weren't as frequent as the other place?
Answer.
Réponse.
Those who were arrested in there were not many arrested in Kampong Chenang, so I could say the arrests in Kampong Chenang were not too frequent.
Can you explain? Even though they weren't that frequent, can you explain how an arrest at Camp Anchenang occurred from what you saw? How did it happen?
Answer. From what I saw,
réponse, d'après ce que j'ai vu,
the person who would be arrested would be called into a meeting, and during which that individual was arrested.
L'individu était arrêté.
And do you know in which direction that individual
question,
was taken?
Dans quelle direction on emmenait cet individu?
Kimbat.
Answer. I do not know.
Réponse.
Where the arrested people were sent to.
Je ne sais pas où étaient envoyées les personnes arrêtées.
Thank you. Now, I'd like to go back to when you were working at Kinyom Kop Sorau, sorry for the pronunciation. Before you went to the airfield, you said there were very frequent arrests in your unit. And if I can just read what you have said to the investigator at the ECC, it's E3/467 English 0020-5073, Khmer 0017-0618 and 9, French 0020-5077. And this is what you said. What did they have you do there? How many people were there? And what were the conditions like? This is at K4 now, not at the airfield. This is before you've arrived at the airfield. And you said, at K4, there were 600 handicapped soldiers. They forced us, the entire unit, to make 4 hectares of rice fields per day. The food was insufficient. Some people died to starvation. I saw 36 to 37 with my own eyes. Tatu was the person in charge of Unit 4, K4. He also came from the North Zone and was later arrested. I don't want to talk about the conditions at Knyom Kop Sarau, but I want to talk about the arrests in your division, in your unit. And you go on to say, did you ever see them arrest people? Why were they arrested? You said, I saw them arrest many people, transporting them by Land Rover. They came to arrest 4 to 10 people every night. They came to arrest them directly at the site. Sometimes they called them to Phnom Penh for arrest. They accused all of those arrested of being CIA links. During those arrests, they tied their arms behind their backs, parrot wing style, stuffed them in bags, and tossed them right into the vehicles. Is this the intense period of arrests that you were talking about before you went to the airfield?
Answer. The frequent arrests happened at Khmuinh.
C'était à Khmuinh qu'avaient lieu les arrestations fréquentes.
And can you explain to the court, in your own words, your own words today, how those arrests would happen? What did you see?
Ces arrestations se déroulaient. Qu'avez-vous vu?
Answer. I would like to inform the chamber as follows.
Réponse. Voici ce dont j'aimerais informer la chambre.
During the time people were arrested,
quand
these people were
arrêtés,
called to a meeting and they were asked to queue.
Réunion, chacun leur tour.
The individual name was called. And then he or she was tied up, kicked into the back, and uploaded into the truck.
On le donnait un coup de pied dans le dos et ensuite on le lançait dans une voiture.
Would everyone from your unit be called to these meetings? Would everyone see it? Or only the people that were arrested were called to the meeting? Can you help us understand what it was like when these arrests were continuing at Knyom Kop Sarau?
Next morning.
Answer. When people were being arrested, as I stated,
les gens
everyone was called into
dit,
a meeting and all of us were asked to queue. And some certain names to be arrested would be called and they had to walk to the front, and after that time they were tied up.
In this intense period of arrest, you have in your statement they came to arrest 4 to 10 people every night. Is that correct? You were being called to meetings every night, and people would be taken out of those meetings and taken away.
Des personnes étaient retirées de la réunion et emmenées.
Answer, yes, that is true.
Réponse, oui, c'est exact.
And from what you remember, even if the meetings are getting smaller and smaller, but how many people were initially at these meetings? How many people from your unit would be going into the meeting? Would it be 10, 20, 40, 100, or the whole unit? Can you explain, please?
50, 100, toute l'unité, pourriez-vous le dire à la chambre?
Allow me to tell the court.
Réponse. Permettez que je dise à la chambre.
Not only my unit was arrested. Numbers of soldiers in the regiment 317 are becoming fewer and fewer.
317 a diminué comme peau de chagrin.
So can you give me, can you give the court an example of the numbers of people that would have had to attend one of those meetings? Is it in the hundreds, or is it in the 20s and 30s, or any other number? How big were they, or how small were they?
Quelle taille avaient ces réunions?
Answer. I could not give my estimate.
Réponse, je ne pourrais pas donner d'estimation.
People disappear from time to time.
Disparaissaient de temps en temps.
And how were the meetings Question. Called? Who would call the meeting? Would it be the unit chief of K4? Or the other unit chiefs?
Les autres chefs
who would call the meeting?
Qui se chargeait de convoquer les réunions?
Answer.
Réponse.
In the unit 317, said the witness.
Dans l'unité 317,
it was not members of unit K4.
Ce n'était pas les membres were arrested. De l'unité 4K4
qui étaient soldiers arrêtés. Of 317,
les soldats
most of them were
de
arrested.
317 étaient pour la plupart, c'était pour la plupart eux qui étaient arrêtés.
Thank you. You've, in your statement, you give some more information about how these arrests occurred. And I'd like to read it to you to see if it refreshes your memory as to the facts. You were asked, who came to make the arrests? And you said, the security people came with the vehicles, with Praesar and tool sling markings. I know that Praesar and tool sling were prisons because the leaders always threatened that anyone who was lazy or who did wrong would be sent to Praesar or tool sling. In 1976, they began to arrest the leaders from the southwest zone, and during 1977, they arrested the leaders from the north zone. They arrested all the leaders from division level down to the squad leaders. I personally saw them arrest chairman of K4, Tatu, the deputy chairman, Tarsen, du chef and Tarum,
who
was in charge of logistics.
Était responsable de la logistique.
Before their arrest,
avant
they called a meeting of the troops, and they called those three to the front. I did not know who made the arrest. They announced that they had come to arrest traitors. I never saw those who were arrested return. Is that correct? You saw the unit chief, the deputy chief, and the man in charge of logistics, Tarum, arrested on that day?
Answer.
Réponse.
During that time, I was in the meeting. I witnessed that incident. I did not conceal the information.
J'ai été témoin de cela. Je n'ai pas.
And you were also asked at E3467. English 00205073, Khmer 00170619, and French 00205077. You answered this question and you, that was asked of you. Aside from the three leaders, did you see them arrest other leaders? And you said, I saw them arrest company chairman Tarsim and Tarveng. In 1977, they arrested Ta-un. They announced that Ta-un, Ta-kim, and Ta-yet were CIA links. They had a meeting in July 1977, and at that time they announced, your leaders are CIA and are traitors. What do you think about that? When all the leaders from the North Zone had been arrested, the South Zone would come to take control in their places. After that, they sent you to Kampong Chenang. My first question is this also correct that you saw these company chairmen Tarsim and Tarveng be arrested?
Answer. I witnessed the arrest,
réponse,
as I told the court.
J'ai vu l'arrestation de mes propres yeux, comme je l'ai dit à la chambre. Question.
Thank you. And just so we understand it a little more,
afin que nous puissions mieux comprendre,
Khmyom Kopsrail, that area, that was it a rice farming area?
Est-ce que c'était une
and then did it have buildings as well?
Y avait-il également
can you explain what that area was? You said you worked there for quite a while. So we understand where these arrests are occurring.
Cela nous permettra de comprendre
the physical layout, if you can.
Comment se déroulaient les arrestations? Pourriez-vous nous décrire physiquement cet endroit? Réponse.
At Kumuin and Kop Sro, the arrest occurred at houses of people who had been evacuated.
Question.
Is it correct that you went to quite a lot of these meetings where people were taken away and arrested? Is that correct?
Answer.
Réponse.
Meetings were held in different locations, and people had been arrested during the meeting. I could swear to this fact that people had been arrested.
And what would make you, what made you go to the meeting? Because obviously, very quickly, you were learning that if you went to the meeting, there was a chance that you would be arrested and taken away. Why would you go to the meetings if you knew that that was like that could happen to you?
Alors que vous saviez ce qu'il pouvait vous arriver à vous.
Witness, I could not get the gist of your question. Could you repeat it?
Votre question, pourriez-vous la répéter?
Perhaps if I do it another way, did you have any choice
question, je vais essayer autrement.
As to whether you went to the meeting
d'aller
or not?
Ou pas à ces réunions?
Answer. I did not have any choice at that time. When I was called into a meeting, I had to be there. If I refused the request or the call, I would be accused of being an enemy.
So who would make the call to go to the meetings? How would you find out in the day that there was a meeting and you must attend? And how would your fellow K4 workers, how would they know to go to the meeting? Who told you? When were you told? How were you told?
Answer.
Réponse.
When chiefs, deputy chiefs, and members of
K4 units
were arrested, cadres from Southwest Zone came to replace them. So there were people responsible for coming and calling people into the meeting.
And did you see whether or not it was the same people that were coming to arrest members of your unit and other units? Was it the same people that came every day or at every meeting? Or did the faces change?
Ou est-ce que les visages changeaient d'une réunion à l'autre?
Réponse. Those who came to arrest people their faces changed. I mean,
n'étaient pas les mêmes, leurs visages changeaient.
And you said that you knew about tool slang and Praisar because you were told it by people that were making the arrests. Is that correct? You were aware of that security facility whilst you were at Knyom Kopsorai?
Cette prison, en étiez-vous au courant lorsque vous travailliez à Kopsorai? Permettez que je dise à la Chambre ceci.
At Khmuin
and Kopsrow.
The cadres of the north were not leaders at that time. Cadres from the southwest zone would make statement that anyone who was lazy would be sent to Tuzlang and Prezor prisons. This is the message that I could recall it from that time.
Thank you. What was the atmosphere like at Khmyom Kopsarao? What was the atmosphere like when these arrests were occurring? Every night, people were being taken away from your unit, other people's units. How did you feel being in that atmosphere? Can you explain to us what it would have been like?
Answer.
We had no feeling in ourselves, and we were afraid of our lives because we could see that arrests happened every day. And as for my case, I was terrified, so terrified and worried at that time.
Thank you. Witness, I'd like to show you a document. I'd like to show you a list with a name on it. And the document number is E3/342. It's the S21 revised prisoner list that contains over 12,000 names of people that were sent to S21. And I'd like to ask you about one name that appears on that list. And Mr. President, I was wondering whether we could show the document on the screen to the witness. We can enlarge it.
President, you can do so.
For reference, the prisoner number is 8967 on the list. The document gets bigger, Your Honours.
It
can be enlarged. Whilst we're waiting for that, Your Honour, if I can just put a statement if I can just put a state, perhaps we'll leave it for today and we'll show the document on Monday. Your Honour, I have a statement to put to the witness that will take about 2 or 3 minutes. If you want to end now, I'm happy to end, otherwise I'll put the statement. A question, a large question.
President, I think it is now the convenient for the adjournment because it is Friday today. The hearing today comes to an end, and we will resume on Monday, on the 15th June. 2015, and the chamber will continue to hear witness Keo Loeur, and then if we have time, we will listen to the testimony of
901.
And actually, 901 was first named as 2TCW 830. Mr. Keo Loeur, the hearing of your testimony has not come to an end yet. You are invited to be here again on 15th of June 2015, starting from 9 a.m. You may rest now. Court officer, please work with Wesu to send this witness, Keo Loeur, back to his residence or to the place where he's staying currently, and bring him back on Monday, 15th of June 2015. Security officer, you are also instructed to bring the two accused, Kyu Sampon and Nguyen Chia, back to the detention facility and have them returned on Monday, 15th of June 2009 at before 9 a.m. The court is now adjourned.